How's it going, everybody? Driver53 here, and today we are going to take another look at the production facilities, and more specifically, we're going to be taking a look here at the Spinnery. I feel like the Spinnery here is kind of like the hidden gem of the production facilities because it doesn't really take a whole lot. I mean, just one cotton harvest, and you can do a lot of producing here at the Spinnery. So let me know down in the comments below, is anybody using this one yet? We will be taking a look at all the other production facilities, and if you want to stay up to date on all those future videos, consider hitting the subscribe button, and if you do, make sure you hit that notification bell too. Before I show you how to make all these colorful bolts of fabric here, let me go ahead and show you where you can find it at in build mode. The first thing you're going to need to do is come down here to construction, and then you're going to come across to your production, then you're going to come down to your factories, and we're going to find the Spinnery here. It's going to be the fifth one. It's going to cost you $60,000, and once you select it, then you're going to be able to place it down. You are going to be able to rotate it with your L1 and R1, and then all you need to do is hit X, and there it is. Here we have the Briar Rose Spinnery. As you can see right here on the side, this is where you're going to manage it. Right here is where your inputs are going to go. This is going to be your cotton and your wool, and then your pallets are going to come out right here. After you place it down, you're going to need to come to your production chains menu here, and you can see that we are on Spinnery right now. What our outputs are, it's going to be fabric wool and fabric cotton. And over here on the right hand side, you can see that our incoming materials are going to be wool and cotton, and our output is going to be fabric. Both inputs make the same output. Here in the middle, you can see that for fabric wool, we have cycles per hour at 2, and the cost per hour is $5. The recipe is 60 wool going in and 30 fabric coming out. For fabric cotton, you can see that it's also 2 cycles per hour. $5 per hour is your cost, and your recipe is 60 cotton going in, yet it's going to be 36 fabric coming out. A little bit better deal here. Now I'd like to go ahead and share with you a chart that I've put together. As you can see, the first column here is going to be for your Spinnery. The second one is going to be your inputs. That's going to be wool and cotton. The third column here is going to be your input storage capacity. This is how much you can actually store in this facility before it won't accept anything more. For both wool and cotton, you can see that it's going to be 45,000 liters. That's really, really nice for your wool. You can just keep bringing those pallets over. The only thing is on your cotton, we know that a full cotton bale, if you're using the square bales, is going to be 20,000 liters. So if you've got a bigger field of cotton, you're going to be able to fill this thing up really, really easy. The next three columns that you can see here, this is going to be your recipe input, your output, and your recipe output. So what that means is your recipe input, you're going to have 60 units of wool and cotton. The output is going to be fabric, and the output is only going to be 30 for wool and 36 for cotton. The next two columns are going to be your input per day and your production per day. First, let's look at input. That's going to be 2,880 liters. That's going to be for both wool and cotton since they both have a recipe input of 60. Your production per day, these are going to be different. On your wool, it's going to be 1,440 per day, but on your cotton, it's going to be 1,728 per day. The next column here is your cost per day. Both of these are going to be $120 per day because we know that it's $5 per hour per each. If you're running both of these, it will be $240. The next column, this is your production per 12-day year. So you're going to be able to produce a total of 17,280 liters of fabric if you're using wool, but if you're using cotton, it's going to be 20,736 liters. Once again, this is going to be to run your facility for an entire 12 days or months if you're playing on single day seasons. The next column you can see here, this is your max storing capacity. This does not include what is out front in your pallets. This is only if you have it set on storing and you fill up that space. It's going to be 4,999 liters. And the last column you can see here, your next factory is going to be the tailor shop. And that's where you can make a lot of money using this product right here. So once again, I want to take a look here at the pallets. You can see that we have 5 pallets. Each pallet is going to be 1,000 liters. So your total storing capacity is going to be almost 10,000 liters. Well, that's going to be it for today, everybody. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. And if you want to stay up to date on all my future videos here for Farming Simulator 22, consider hitting that subscribe button. And if you do, hit the notification bell too. And don't forget about Driver's Crew. Have a great day, night, evening, everybody. Till next time, this is Driver53, signing off.